My brothers and sisters, good morning. To God be the glory. Great things he hath done. So loved he the world that he gave us his only begotten son. Want to thank God this morning for the opportunity to once more come and share his words with you. Let me also state that the Greater Portmore Tabernacle does not own the rights to the music or any parts of it that was just played in your hearing. This morning, I want to thank God for the privilege afforded me to come and share, to kick the week off with the daily morning devotions. Let us pray. We thank you, O God, for this morning. Lord, as we come to share your word and to enter in the new week of hearing from you, I pray right now, God, that you will speak through me with clarity. Let your word go forth and bless the hearts of the hearers, and that those who will hear this word will be blessed by this word. We tell you thanks right now, God. Bless all those who will join, all those who will come and view and listen, and those will view at a later time. At the end of all of this, Lord, my goal is that your name be glorified. This is not about me. I'm just a vessel that you have chosen. Be glorified, no God, as I tell you thanks in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. Let me welcome those who are viewing right now. Let me also welcome those who will view at a later time. And I just want to, you know, wanted to just share this time with me. I'm reading to you today from the book of St. John, and I'm sticking in John chapter 4, as the word came to me this morning. allow me to share the word with you. John 4, 13 to 16 is where I'm going to start this morning. Jesus said unto her, "Everyone who drinks this water will be thirsty again. But whoever drinks the water that I give him will never be thirsty again. But the water that I give him will become in him a spring of water, satisfying his thirst for God, welling up, continually flowing, bubbling within him to eternal life." The woman said to him, "Sir, give me this water so that I'll not get thirsty, nor have to continually come all the way here to draw." At this, Jesus said, "Go, call your husband." Allow me to read also verse 17, because I want to, let me go to verse 18 rather. Let me go to verse 18. The woman responded to Jesus, "Sir, I do not have a husband." Jesus said to her, "You have correctly said, I do not have a husband. For you have had five husbands, and the man you are now living with is not your husband. You have said this truthfully." I want to look at three aspects of this story. The conversation, the confession, and the conversion. I believe that every conversation with Jesus should lead to a confession. And having made a confession, acknowledging who we are, acknowledging what we are in him, it should lead to a conversion. What was the conversation that Jesus and this woman had? We are not told, though we are given a lot of what was said in the conversation, because we all know the woman's reputation. Yes, John just disclosed that Jesus said to her, "You have had five husbands, and the one you're now living with is not yours." So we understand possibly the kind of woman that we're dealing with here. We understand possibly the nature of this woman and where this conversation would have led and what it would have led to. And we know the story that she was there sitting at the well when Jesus approached her. Jesus was sitting at the well when she came up to draw water. And I often, with my dramatic, creative mind, I often paint a picture that once this woman was coming towards the well and saw Jesus, who must have been a handsome guy, must have been worth looking on, she must have been thinking in her mind, "I wonder if this guy will talk to me. I wonder if this guy will like me." But she would have also observed that by his dressing, he was not of her type, because Jews would have dressed differently from Gentiles or Samaritans. But when Jesus, when the approach was made, he said to her, "Give me water." And the conversation built up, and they talked, and he spoke to her, and she said, "You know who gave us this well, and who drank, and he drank from the well himself, he watered his cattle here, and his sons would have drank from the well." And she started to give him all the traditions. Morning, my brothers and sisters, everybody who has joined me, God bless you. And Jesus said to her, "If you only know who it is that you talk to, you would have given me this water." And her ears would have perked up and her interest was piqued at that time. And Jesus said to her, "No, everyone who drinks from this well or who drinks this water is going to be thirsty again. But the water I want to give you, when you drink it, you don't need to come back here." Now, at this time of the day, it was about midday. Being that the area was desert and sandy and hot, it was not the common time for people to go to the well to draw water. But because of the nature of this woman, she could not go to the well in the afternoon when all the other women were at the well. As we say in Jamaica, because hell would have broke loose down at the well. Because it is obvious, and it would have been obvious, that there would have been somebody who wanted to have a dialogue with this woman because of maybe her husband. But so she chose midday to go and get her water. You know, so while she was there and she had a conversation with Jesus, and Jesus said to her, "Everyone who drinks of this water will be thirsty again. But the water I will give you, you will never be thirsty again, because this water will become in him a spring of water satisfying for his thirst for God." And I'm using the Amplified Version. And Jesus continues to say, "This water will be welling up, continually flowing, bubbling within him." This is the kind of promise that Jesus is making to somebody this morning. That what I have to give you is not just going to satisfy you now. It is going to satisfy you tomorrow. It is going to satisfy you the day after. It is going to continue to satisfy you. That every time you drink this water, you will be continuously satisfied. This is what Jesus is promising to somebody today. It was because of her thirsty lifestyle why she was at the well at that time. But sometimes we have to thank God, because our choice of living, the way we choose to live our lives at time, will in most cases lead us to have an encounter with Jesus Christ. This woman's lifestyle led her to have an encounter with Jesus at a time when nobody would have been having that encounter with Jesus. At first, she was basically drawn back, because she was saying that you're a Jew, I'm a Samaritan, how can you ask me for water? But Jesus did not want water from her. He wanted to give her something different. And my friends, this is what Jesus wants to give us this week. He wants to give us something different, right? So as I said earlier, we don't know all of what they spoke about. But one thing we know is that they had a conversation. We know that they had a dialogue. Some talking back and forth went on. And they had a long conversation. And the conversation got interesting. Because the woman in verse 15 said to Jesus, "Give me this water so that I will not thirsty again, to have to continually come here to draw water." Now, I want to point this out, because many people want what God has to give, want what Jesus has to give, and they want to continue living their lives the way they are living their lives now, and want the gifts of Jesus Christ. It doesn't work like that. You can't want the gift that Jesus is giving you in the same old lifestyle that you're living. Because the scriptures tell us that you can't pour new wine into old wineskin, because the fermentation of it can cause the seams to crack, and it can damage the old wineskin, and all that new wine is going to waste. So if you want this eternal water, if you want this eternal thirst quenching water that Jesus Christ is offering, you have to be willing to change your lifestyle. And so the woman made a confession here when Jesus said to her, Basically, Jesus is saying to her, I can't give you this water as you are. So guess what? Go call your husband and come back. The woman said to him, I do not have a husband. God Almighty. Which was so true. Because indeed she never had a husband. She had somebody's husband. Jesus pointed out her faults to her. He said to her, you have spoken truthfully. When you have a conversation with Jesus, a conversation with Jesus leads to soul searching. A conversation with Jesus leads to you revealing your heart to him because he already knows your heart. When you have a conversation with Jesus, it leads you to make a confession of who you truly are. Because guess what? He already knows who you truly are. You can't lie to him. Nothing. You can't hide, as my brother is saying there. You can't hide anything from Jesus. Yeah, brother Haiti. They want the gifts of God, but not a relationship with God. This woman evidently wanted the gift. And she wanted to get this gift that she don't have to thirst again and go home to husband number six, who is not hers. But in order to carry home the gift of Christ, in order to carry home the gift of eternal life, the gift of eternal water, you have to first get rid of husband number six that is not yours. You have to go home, you have to clean house. Whether the physical house or the spiritual house, you have to first clean house and make space for the gift of God. Hallelujah. You have to get rid of the things, the cobwebs that are there in your life. You have to get rid of the dust that is there in your life. You have to get rid of the slime and the germs and everything that has been backed up in a corner that you have been nurturing and hoarding. You have to get rid of that so that you make space for that water that Jesus Christ wants to give you. And so Jesus said to her, yes, you have spoken correctly because you have had 5 husbands. Number 6 that you live with is not yours. And so this woman pondered what Jesus said to her. And I believe she looked in her life and she said, I have to do something. Because this man speaks to me with love. How this man is speaking to me. He looks at me in my fault and he loves me. He looks at me in my terrible condition and he loves me just the same. This man is speaking to me with respect. He doesn't lust after my body. He's not telling me that I'm sexy. He's not telling me anything about my hair and my face and my body. This man is talking to me with a kind of love that I have never expected before. That I've never experienced before. Because guess what? At that point, this woman found husband number 7, the perfect husband. She found husband number 7, the perfect husband. I believe that this woman, having had a conversation with Jesus Christ, having had an opportunity to make a confession, to say, I have no husband. My life is not right. My life is a mess as it is. I am living with somebody who is not mine. I'm living with somebody who does not belong to me. I am living with somebody who, and my property, other people's property. But guess what? I want to go home with husband number 7. Because this man loves me with all my faults. That's what the woman was saying. That's what the woman experienced. And God wants somebody to experience that same experience that the woman experienced. It was well indeed at the well with husband number 7. I want you to understand that know that you, when the woman made this confession, she cleaned house. And by cleaning house, she now made room for what God was about to give her. She made space for that living water. That water that would see her not being thirsty for God anymore. Not being thirsty to be for emotional satisfaction anymore. She would not be thirsty for spiritual satisfaction anymore. She would still need the water from the well. But her greater need, her deeper needs would be met by accepting the water of living, the living water of eternal life. This was what God was offering to her. And so, having had the conversation with Jesus and having made a confession, this woman did the third and final thing. She was now converted. So we see the conversion taking place. And you say, Brother Tyrone, but I don't see a conversion taking place in verses 13 to 18. Follow me then as we go over to verse 28 and 29. Because when the conversation and Jesus got an opportunity to speak, not to the woman's ears, not to the woman's physique, but he spoke to her spirit. And this is what we need to get to, brothers and sisters, and the ministers on this watch this morning. I want us, when we speak this word, we need to speak this word to people's spirit. When God gives us an opportunity to deliver this word, we need to deliver this word to people's spirit. And so this morning, I want you to understand that the reason why a conversion took place in this conversation with the woman and Jesus is because Jesus got an opportunity to minister to the woman's spirit, not to her ears and not to her physical needs. He ministered to her spirit and her spiritual needs. And so, in verse 28 and 29, we read, and I'm reading from the King James, "The woman then left her water pot and went her way into the city." Sorry. I want you to pay close attention to what John writes, because he said she went her way into the city and she said to the men. More than likely, it would have been men who she was with before, who she has been with before. It would have been men who wanted to be with her. It would have been men who yearned for an opportunity to spend some time with her. It would have been men who grieve because they never got a chance to be with her. And here she was now. She ran back to the city and she identified with the men. And she said, "Come, see a man." God Almighty, thank you, Jesus. She said, "Come, see a man which told me all things that ever I did. Is not this the Christ?" So in the conversion process, we saw three things happening. She left her reason for the source. She left her reason for coming to the well to draw a little pot of water. She left that reason for the source of living water. She left the well for Jesus. Her conversion sent her to speak to the men. And so she left her reason for coming to the well with a new reason. She left with the source of living water. The second thing we saw, she saw her faults and her failures. As she spoke to Jesus, she saw her faults and her failures, and she dropped those and accepted the Father. Not the Father Jacob who gave them the well. Not the fathers who have passed on before, but she accepted God the Father, who was now the source of her salvation. The final thing we saw is that she called the men of the city to the man of salvation. She called the men of the city to the man of salvation. Here's her word as I seek to close. She said, come. She said to the men, come, see a man. And you can imagine being people, everybody, some of that, everybody, but most of them might be saying, what? She find a new man. Lord have mercy, I wish I could change her lifestyle. I wish I could do better. She find a new man again. But guess what? Even while they may have been saying that, they were still coming to the well. And they came to the well for whatever reason they came. They did come to the well. And when the men came, and I believe some women came too. But when they came to the well, they realized that this man that she now found, this man that she now encountered, was a man with a difference. It was now the man who loved her for who she was and what she could have been. She found the man that loved her for who she was and for what he wanted her to be. She was no longer thirsty. Her thirst was quenched. And she could have now left the well. She went there as the curse of the city. But she left the well as the cure for the city, because she now had a word for the city. How will you leave? How will you leave the well? When you go to the well, how will you leave the well? Are you thirsty this morning? Are you thirsty this morning? If you're thirsty, I'm inviting you. Come, see a man who knows everything about you and is willing to love you just as you are. Come, see a man who knows all your secrets, but is willing to embrace you with your faults. This man is Jesus Christ. The woman carried out, as the comment says there, this woman carried out the purpose of the church to call people to Christ. And we need to get back to that place. I challenge you this morning to call somebody and say, come, see a man. Hallelujah. As we listen some more to this song, let us ponder in our hearts what we need to do. We need to get busy. We need to get busy and start calling people and say, come, see a man who knows everything about me and loves me just the same. His name is Jesus. Let us pray. Mighty God, as you have empowered us this morning through your word, I pray, God, that we would have been so challenged that we would leave from here and that would go back into a city, whichever city it would be, and that would call men and women unto you and say, come, see a man, the man of all times. Come, see a man who has the ability and the capabilities to love us the way we ought to be loved, to love us with our sinful condition and our faults, and that we would bring that change to the world. We give you thanks this morning for your word, and I thank you for the opportunity to have been able to share your word. We pray your blessing upon the ones who will share tomorrow and Wednesday. I believe it's Brother Aiti who will share tomorrow. I pray, God, that you'll bless him, give him a word for the time, and that others will be challenged by the word. We give you thanks, mighty God. Thank you for Reverend Lewis and his family. We thank you for the greater Pope Moore and the Spanish Town Tabernacle, who continue to bless us and bless others by sharing your word. Be glorified, we ask, in Jesus' holy name. Amen and amen. God bless you, my friends. God bless you. Have a thirst feelings day. Go to the fountain. Get that water that will continue to well up inside of you. Continues to flow inside of you. Hallelujah. Bless you, my brother Roshan. Bless you. Bless your sister Simone, sister Anne Marie. God bless you. God bless your brother IT. Thanks. And God bless all the others who would have joined. Sister Sarah Elliott, sister Dennis. God bless you. Sister Walker, I saw you somewhere. Sister Herma Wall. God bless you. Paula Ewan. God bless you. Sarah Elliott. And all of you would have viewed and were blessed. Thank you for blessing me with your presence. Sister Shoshana, my friend all the way from Denham Town Baptist, God bless you. God bless you. God bless you all, my brothers and sisters. Thanks for the strength. Thanks for the encouragement. And thank you, Sister Tracy Lamont. God bless you. Hallelujah. God bless you for your comments. God bless you for your strengthening. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thirst no more, Sister Evelyn Grant. God bless you, Sister Grant. Hallelujah. Thirst no more. As you go through your day, the Spirit of the Lord be with you. Amen and amen.